In this GIMP workshop, we will see a way how to use the Path tool and also how to blur the background. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the description. When GIMP is already open, we can open our image folder and bring our image into GIMP by drag and drop. Now we click on the little zoom icon in the top right to maximize it. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. Go ahead and make two duplicates by clicking the Duplicate button in the Layers panel twice. Then we make the middle as well as the bottom layer invisible by clicking both eyes. Go to the toolbox and activate the Paths tool. Zoom in by pressing the Ctrl key and turning the mouse wheel. Selecting a certain area works best when we stay just a little bit inside the area that we want to select. Go ahead and click the first anchor. Then click the second anchor, but do not release the mouse button, but drag it out so the handles become visible. And by moving the handle, we can make a curve. Then, when the curve is to our liking, we let go of the left mouse button. Now we click and drag the handle back in the direction of its anchor. We place it close near this anchor and already in the direction of our next to make anchor. We can, by click and drag the other handle, still make some corrections to this curve, if necessary. Go ahead and click the next anchor. Again, do not release the mouse, but drag it out to show the handles and to make a curve. Then we can release the mouse. Click again in the handle and drag it close near the last anchor and place it in the direction of the next anchor. Here too, we can grab the other handle to make corrections if we want. Now click the next anchor, hold the mouse, pull out the handles and make the curve. Then release the mouse, click again in the handle and move it back to the anchor and place it in the direction of the next anchor. We can, with Ctrl Z, undo one or more previous steps. Then we can try again. When we press the spacebar, the cursor changes into the Move tool and we can, by moving our mouse without clicking, move the image. Now we will make a straight line. Click where you want the straight line to end. Then release the mouse button right away. But we can, by click and drag, still move this anchor. Then we click our next anchor, hold the mouse and drag out the handles to make a proper curve. Then let go of the mouse, click again in the handle and move it back to its anchor and, again, place it in the direction of the next to make anchor. In this way, we can make a very precise path, which we will later change into a selection. For the sake of the tutorial, we will go fast forward now. When we are close to the first anchor, we place the cursor on the first anchor and press and hold the Ctrl key. Then the cursor shows a little chain, and now we can click to close our first path. When our path is closed, we can still make corrections. Press the Ctrl key and click an anchor somewhere on the path. Release the Ctrl key, and then we can make corrections by dragging the anchor or the handles. In this way, we can make corrections everywhere on the path. Now zoom out by pressing the Ctrl key and turning the mouse wheel again. When this is all done, we can make a new path around the areas through which we can still see the background, such as by the suitcase, the left arm, and the feet. This can be done, of course, in the same way as we made our first path. Now we will again go fast forward. All done, go to View, Zoom, and Fit Image in Window. Then we go to the Tool Options and click Selection from Path. The different paths will automatically add up to one selection. Then we click in the toolbox or random tool to make the path invisible. Back to Select and hit Feather. Here we feather the selection with 5 pixels. And just click OK. Again to select and now to invert. Then to edit, and here we click Clear, so the background is removed. Back to Select and hit None. Go to the Layers panel and make the top layer invisible. Make the middle layer visible and select it. Then we go to Filters in the menu bar, click Blur, and then Gaussian Blur. Drag the dialog box to the top of your screen. Hover over the right bottom corner, and when the cursor changes into a diagonal double arrow, we can pull out the window. Move the image in the preview pane. Make the blur radius for both the horizontal and the vertical 100. Then we can click the preview off and on to see the difference. Now hit OK. Make the top layer and the bottom layer visible and select the top layer. In the toolbox, we select the Eraser tool. Go ahead and make the opacity somewhere about 25. Choose Brush Hardness 0.25 and leave its size on the default 20. Zoom in to the hair and blur the edge of the hair a bit to make it look more natural. When you feel it's OK, click View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Then we go back to the tool options and make the opacity about 50 or 60. Then we make the size somewhere about 800. Select the middle layer and erase the bottom area in one or two strokes. And there we have it, an easy and effective way to make a selection using the Paths tool and to make a nice transition from sharp to unsharp in the background. I hope you liked this video. If so, please like, subscribe and leave a nice comment to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.